So then, Season of the Splicer is Destiny's next DLC. The Vex are threatening the safety of the Lost City and we have to stop them. So yeah, nothing new, business as usual, kill Vex and party on. Having said that, it is a brand new season, so what's new? There's 3 new exotic armor pieces, one of which has an anti-stasis perk. And speaking of stasis, this new exotic sidearm can freeze your foes. Yeah, we're balls deep in a stasis arms race. For real, there's a whole host of legendary stasis weapons too. There's also a new 6-player matchmade activity, Override, in which you have to take out the Vex inside their bizarre neon network. And move over, Baby Yoda, there's a new alien kid in town. Look, fallen babies, all as snug as a bug in a rug. What's going on? Do we hug them? Do we throw them into a meat grinder? So many conflicting emotions. And at last, Season of the Splicer will finally introduce Transmog, allowing you to look as ridiculous as you want. And trust me, there are some truly ridiculous looking new armor pieces. Plus the return of Vault of Glass, Solstice of Heroes, a secret Splicer emblem which I'll show you how to get, new sources for pinnacle drops, and well, the list goes on. So yeah, lots to talk about, let's effing well do this. Right, let's start with those new exotic armor pieces. Say hello to Star Eater Scales, the new exotic hunter leg armor. Collecting power orbs charges your super more quickly and makes it more potent. I mean, it's about time Hunter's got a decent exotic armor piece, and this is it, my go-to exotic for Season of the Splicer. Next up, exotic titan leg armor, the Path of Burning Steps. This naughty little minx converts solar kills into increased weapon damage and makes you more difficult to lock down with stasis. Yes, this is our first piece of anti-stasis armor, a godsend no doubt for Crucible. I gotta say, this is one dangerous bit of kit. Next up, Warlock leg armor, Boots of the Assembler. This condenses your Rift's healing or empowering energy into projectiles that seek out their allies to bless them with noble benefits. So, you know, if you see a teammate wearing these, give them a hug and say thank you. Next up, the exotic stasis sidearm, Cryosthesia 77K. Yeah, I know it's got a silly name, but you know what? I embrace the silliness. Bungie, the sillier the better. Now, you obtain this new exotic from the season pass, which we'll look at in just a moment. And as you can see from the gameplay, it's a stasis powered sidearm with liquid cooling tech. In other words, it can freeze stuff. So yeah, you can get instant access to this new exotic from the first rank of the paid season pass, or if we scroll along to the right here, you can also obtain this weapon from rank 35 of the free season pass. Next up, the new 6-player matchmade activity, Override. 5 teams of 6 will use splicer technology to hack the Vex network, uncover their secrets, steal their code, and use their power against them. In short, you gotta kill a load of Vex in a crazy new environment. Now, in order to get your hands on this new splicer tech, you'll be teaming up with the fallen Kel Mithrax. Only he possesses the knowledge needed to combat the Vex technology that ensnares the Lost City. Good luck! And check it out, each week of Season 14, there will be a brand new pinnacle mission that takes place within the Vex network. Now, these weekly pinnacle missions appear as important dates on the Season of the Splicer content calendar, so be sure to tune in. Not only for the loot, but for some unique seasonal content too. This will no doubt build up to the season finale. And after the final pinnacle mission, we'll get this Solstice of Heroes event the following week on July 6th. Expect some more unique Solstice armor to grind out. Next up, the new Transmog system that will allow you to convert the old armor in your collections into universal armor ornaments, thus giving you far more customization options to play around with. So then, Ada is the key to this new Transmog system, and as you can see, she's standing in front of a giant loom. And here is the loom in all its glory. Now listen up, because if you want to convert old armor pieces into universal ornaments, you'll need to follow this rather tedious process. First, kill enemies. Defeated enemies drop a material called Synth Strand. You can use Synth Strand to purchase bounties that when completed will award you with Synth Cord. You can then use Ada's loom here to transform your Synth Cord into this new material, Synth Weave. And it's this effing material that allows you to convert an old armor piece from your collection into a universal armor ornament. Like I said, it's a bit of a tedious process. In Season of the Splicer, you'll be able to earn a max of 20 Synth Weave per class, which means in Season 14, my Hunter can only convert 20 pieces of armor from my collections into universal ornaments. It's worth noting that after Season of the Splicer, we'll only be able to unlock 10 Synth Weave per class, so be sure to take advantage of this season's increased allowance. Now, if you're lazy or you don't have enough time to grind out Synth Weave, you can purchase it from Eververse. 1 Synth Weave will cost you 300 silver, and 5 Synth Weave will cost you 1,000 silver. Next up, the Vault of Glass raid. It kicks off May 22nd at 10 a.m. Pacific time. And just so you know, the opening area of the Vault of Glass raid is a private space only. Sadly, you won't be able to zoom off and explore the rest of Venus. Athian awaits, Guardians, a good luck. And check it out, if you want this secret Season 14 emblem right now. I've left a code for it in the description box below. Simply redeem it on Bungie.net. So yeah, Season of the Splicer. What do I actually think about what's been revealed? Well, let's start with the story. It's always nice to see old characters return and fleshed out, and that's exactly what we're getting with the fallen Kel Mithrax. Now, just in case you didn't already know, Mithrax has actually cameoed in previous Destiny content, most notably in the Zero Hour quest and in a Taken King campaign mission, in which you're actually given the option to either save him or kill him. Well, whether you chose to kill him or not, Mithrax now has an entire season based around him. After all, he's the dude with the knowledge to combat the Vex technology that ensnares the Last City. As for this new Vex threat, well, let's be honest, it's a pretty tired plot at this point. Enemy threatens city, kill enemy, save city. We've done it countless times before. Having said that, I guess Bungie had to involve the Vex in order to tie in the Vault of Glass raid to this season's narrative. The Vault of Glass, as anyone who's played it will tell you, is a Vex-themed raid. So yeah, it makes sense that there's a Vex threat this season. Now, if you haven't already experienced the Vault of Glass, you're in for a treat. Many consider it Destiny's best raid. Now, the new 6-player activity override looks like solid fun, taking out waves of Vex in a crazy new location. But having said that, it's nothing we've not done a million times before. To be honest, it's really the Tron-style neon aesthetics that has sold this new activity to me. Now, one gripe I do have about this season that has been echoed in the community is the tedious process for converting armor from your collections into universal armor ornaments. I'm also not keen on capping the amount you can earn each season. I mean, I do like the idea of earning these ornaments, I just hope the whole process isn't so time consuming that reaching the cap before the season ends becomes an impossible chase. In general though, I'm looking forward to this new season, getting my hands on that exotic hunter leg armor and getting into my weekly power grind. Oh, and just for the record, I killed Mithrax in that mission, and if I see any of those fallen hatchlings, well, let's just say I ain't no effing Mandalorian. I'm curious, thumbs up if you're in love with the fallen hatchlings, thumbs down if you want to send them screaming to hell. Subscribe for more Season 14 content and we'll speak again very soon. Stay safe, you absolute legends. Thank you for watching. Take care.